But anyways, off the tattoos, gloves, polio region shit, all kind of
stuff. You gotta leave enough room for three other belts.
Well, I got room on my ankles and shit. I'm keeping the stress around us.
Jermell, it seems like you and Jermall, you guys are getting known as having like the fiercest, you guys bring that most fierce energy into the ring and intensity. Why do you think that is?
This one I gotta go. They're like, I can't even see you, I can't even respect you as a man.
It's not about
I gotta look you in your eyes, and if you're looking away, I'm done talking to you.
Yeah.
It's my dad talking. But listen, the world of boxing is starting to just now, you know, peep game on the Charlos. Mm-hmm. We actually been this way, we've been these people. I'm not putting on my front for you. All I can say is that y'all keep on watching us, and I guess you'll keep liking us. I mean, the ones that wasn't believers, I can see a few non-believers around me right now, and I appreciate them being believers, and all due respect to them. I care for the ones that started with me. You know, I care for the ones that really love me and respect each other and what we've been through.
Well, where do you think you and your brother get that intensity from that you bring into the ring? Where's that come from?
Well, my uncle back there, he grew up with my father. He realized father kind of raised us wrong, you know, but I guess that made me who the man I am today, and my brother who he is today. He's a family man, and he's a stud as well, so I don't know how to tell you.
What do you think about, because it seemed like you're the hottest fighter at 54, getting all the knockouts. So why isn't it Jermell Charlo against Lara or Jermell Charlo against her?
Well, when you enter my world, you enter the Jermell Charlo show, so I care less about the next opponent. The most important thing is us to continue to build our legacy. 154 is my division. Humble as I can come, I never tell people that this is my division, because I'm hungry. And the way I lose my hunger in boxing, and it has happened to me before as a professional, but I'm undefeated, 30-0. I lost my hunger before. I got it back, though. And the way I get it back is very easy. I'm feeling so doubted. And thank to you media, and thank to all the people that doubted the Trump and the Charlos, we did what we have to do. We silenced them. We shut them up. We hopefully continue to shut them up. 2018 is very specific for us because PBC is doing some things that we didn't expect. They're giving really, really close attention to the fighters. And with that being said, we have to come in here. We have to really, 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 really have our life together outside the ring, inside the ring. And 2018 is something that I've been working on. If y'all want to hear from us, y'all want to hear more from us, the best thing I can say is just, you know, really lock in with the Charlos. And like when I say lock in, I mean like lock in deep. I got fans that really lock in deep with me, and I know who they are because they actually tell me things that I wouldn't expect them to know. And if a boxing writer can do those things, it's awesome. Boxing Ego came out to the workout a couple weeks ago, and it was astounding to him to see the gym. And like he really looked at the facility like, damn, I see where it comes from. The hunger is just within me. The hunger is not what I'll show you. I care less to show the fans and the media and the people how hungry I am, because that's why y'all lose the urge to watch me, and then y'all start calling out these gay guys and Google and all these other boxers. I don't even want to say those words, but thank you all. It ain't alcohol. I do drink. It's water.
So, who do you want to knock out next?
Well, the problem is I can't control who I fight next. I wish I could just say, grab that guy, but I hope I can fight somebody that got a weak chin and I can just knock them out. Mix some of these, right? Yeah, because y'all know I hit hard. I showed that, and I keep showing him that. Every time I step in the ring, I see you, guy. Like, he be with all kind of boxes, and they're waking me up all the time. I'm like, he be with all kind of boxes. I don't know who he rocking with. I like you, but I don't like you because you rock with a lot of boxes, and I want you to rock with me. You with me, though? You with me?
Which one are you?
See, I'm when he asked that question, he said the first or the second one. Mm-hmm. I signed with Al second.
Okay.
Wait, I turned pro first, though.
It's a tie. You know how I feel. I love both of y'all.
Have you hit your prime yet, do you think?
I do want to retire at 30 years old. I'm 27 right now. I got 3 more years where I really want to be. I never told nobody that, but I possibly could get it done. But I'm not where I want to be as far as success, so I try my best to try to build that up. That's why I open the gym, and that's why I try to build my city around me and not me around my city, because Houston don't support the come up. They support the up, you know. And I don't think that's just Houston. I think that's a lot of places. But I haven't hit my prime. I'm still building that. The way I know that is because, like, when I look at myself and I look at guys like Lauren, I'm like, wait, he way older than me. I'm 27. And I'm where I'm at. I don't care about, I'm no matter who you fight. You put your life on the line when you fight. I put my life on the line every time I fight, so I got 30 people that I beat. Long dick. You know, so I don't know about her record. Already undefeated. I don't study guys until I, 2 or 3 weeks before the fight. I live me, I do me, and I'm happy where I'm at.
Can you speak to, you said you lost your hunger and you got it back. Can you speak to the actual moment that you lost your hunger and the moment you actually got it back?
Yeah, well, you know, I thought I had a little money in my pocket. You know what I'm saying? I thought I was living a life and a dream come true until I realized that buying a Rolls Royce wasn't the most important move in my life. Buying a Rolls Royce was like, should have happened after like where I'm at now. You know, thank God I still got that car, but damn, like, can we refinance them all? Anybody understand that? But I got my hunger back when I got ready to fight again. It like made me feel like, damn, I should.
What fight was that?
Man, that's crazy, man. It's crazy.
Was it out here in the main when all three of us?
No. When I fought John Jackson,
that's when
I got my hunger back.
That's what I was looking at.
Yeah. I got ready to fight for a world title that I never thought I would get. You know, I got ready to defend myself and defend my brother. Man, bro, I had more pressure on me during that fight than I had in my whole career, my whole life, everything. Even having a kid, I felt more nervous than that night because my brother wanted to make history. The only way my brother could make history is in me winning that night. And I got it done. I was losing that fight. I had a lot of pressure on me, bro. But that fight also was a fight on my transition from Ronnie Shields to Derrick James and listening and applying myself in the corner. A lot of people don't know that boxers have to understand what's going on, what your coaches are seeing at the same time of you trying to really dictate the fight. So I got to tell him shut up. I got to tell him let me hear. I got to tell him stop yelling at me in the red round. It feels like I had a whole bunch of that. You can go back over the fight. I get mad every time I watch. I don't want no, you can never talk to me crazy. I don't need disrespect. Damn don't need disrespect in between the time I put my life on the line. So I'm out of that situation. And I don't think Derrick James will ever disrespect me because we're like best friends. We talk every day. It's like, what's up, Doug? Boy, don't call me, boy. Tell him to tell coach. I'm just waking up. You know, that's the coach I got. So I'm very happy to have him in my life in transition. Earl Smith has been one of the best things that happened to me in my career. Earl's Landy Laura was someone that I sparred with for years and years and years. And I was there to help him get better. I wasn't there to help myself get better. But the advantage that I had in this whole situation is me taking advantage of the trainer that I had with Earl's Landy Laura. It wasn't the advantage that, oh, he better than me or none of that. No, the advantage of like me sparring with a Cuban, me getting the work that I need, and then all of a sudden, I make that transition and become a man, and then I start sparring with a man that I feel like is a man, and that's spent. The man hit hard, even hard as I've ever been hit in my life. The man trained aggressively. I can't look at him slack because I'm going to be wiped out. Coach will know that I'm not on my P's and Q's because of the training that I have lost. I mean,
what's the secret sauce in that?
The temperature. The temperature in the ring. They don't take no more. That's it.
Were you disappointed when Derrick James didn't get trainer of the year? Can you speak to that?
I still feel like Derrick James did get trainer of the year. Much respect to Ring because they recognize it. I didn't get fighter of the year. Maybe 18 is what it is. But, you know, once Earl unified, you know, and I unified, then what you going to say about my coach? Can you say? You know, he better than Ronnie Shields to me. And I don't care what they think. And I'm better than every fighter Ronnie Shields has, even my twin brother. And eventually, everybody understand that. Period. And I'm flyer than everybody. They can't touch me.
You kind of look like you know, one of their fighters. You know, kind of look
like I'm better. Skillfully. I feel like me and my brother got close to the same power, and I'm 54.
Jamel,
what about your career? You're mentally, you're stronger now than you were when you started out. You have confidence, but how has it changed? How have you changed physically in the ring? Things that you do.
I sit on my punches more. You know, all that moving is done. What am I moving for? You ain't better than me. So till you become somebody that really put a threat in my life. It's a wrap. Like, I'm coming forward. Put that pressure. You got to bag me up. Period. I don't care who here is. They got to bag me up. And until I realize they can bag me up, don't forget, I box. I really started off a boxer, a mover, a punch and stick and hit. Don't touch me. I don't like getting messed up. You feel me? I've seen crazy things happen in boxing, so I don't want to get hit. So therefore, with that being said, I got my mindset right. I want to win. Okay, what it take? Just a knockout.
We can credit that to Derrick James.
You can credit that to Ronnie Shields because Ronnie Shields taught that skill as far as movement. Derrick James taught that power. Y'all seen them knockouts lately? Y'all see the Earl doing the same thing I'm doing? Y'all see kind of similarities? The coach ain't, the coach teaches. He spends a lot of quality time teaching me as well. That's what I like about him.
Were you surprised at all that you got Lubin out of there in the first round?
Very much. I was surprised. I thought I was getting ready for a fight. I was getting ready for the biggest war of my life. My next fight, June 9th, I'm getting ready for the biggest war of my life. I won't accept an opponent that's just somebody easy. I want somebody that can punch me. You know, I do want him to have a little chin, little light chin on him. It's hard to make 7 figures off a knockout in the first round. Did it before, we're going to do it again. I told Lubin that. Y'all heard me preach that the whole time. I didn't want to be in no press conferences. I didn't want to train for no Lubin. And now I'm the champ of the world. I defended twice against ranked number one guys. Knocked both of them out. Knocked out the guy to fight the title. You got to either pay me or give me somebody life. What you think, what?
I'm with you, Sam.
Well, do you think it's Sam? You think in a weird
way? He's all this in your ear.
You think in a weird way?
He talk to me outside the ring. He going to hype your ass up, though.
If you can understand it.
Right.
You think it hurt a little bit that you got him out in one and made him look like he isn't as good as a challenge as he really was, kind of thing?
I don't even like that question. No, I did what I had to do. I did what I had to do, period. Everybody unexpected that. I didn't expect it. It was a surprise to me. But that let y'all know that I pack a punch. I could barely touch him and do what I did to Lubin. Lubin gonna knock out a lot of guys. He might knock out the next 5 guys. I won't get Lubin another. I won't give him another rematch until he worked for him. Because I really feel like he didn't deserve that first match. So I have to acknowledge him to create that. So for him to get to WBC, if I got it, title contingency, he won't be getting it, period. I don't fight rematches. I ain't had one in the yet. I heard Vines had one in his mouth. He got promotional problems. The man really can't take a punch. And I fought him when I was a kid. So I really want to show Sam Watson that I knocked boys out. And I guarantee you that getting the ring, I'm knocking him out. Giannis, Monterosa, I'm practicing and knocking him out. I'm practicing and I'm making him happen. They better be cool. Stop talking to Sam. Don't say nothing. Don't run your mouth.
Jermell, so if it's...
How long can you stay at 54? Did the fantasy fights going up, or do you think you can stay there for a while? Because you and your brother are... Yeah, okay.
Well, I follow you on Instagram. You
play that shit.
Yeah.
He said, you okay? That answer. I'll play that. I'm going to push
you. I'm champion 54. I got to maintain there. That's where the money at. I move up, I lose my bread.